prove that the series cos of 1 by n is divergent. Solution. Here, un is taken as cos of 1 by n, which is positive for all n. And hence, this given series is a series of positive terms. Now, let us find the limit of un. Limit of un as n tends to infinity is equals to limit of cos of 1 by n as n tends to infinity. As n tends to infinity, 1 by infinity tends to 0. Therefore, cos 0. Cos 0 is 1, which is not equals to 0. Thus, the series of positive terms whose nth term is not equal to 0. Therefore, by sufficient condition for divergent series, the given series, namely series cos of 1 by n, diverges since it is series of positive terms and diverges to plus infinity. That is, we know that if a series un of positive term is such that limit of un is not equal to 0, then the series un diverges and diverges to plus infinity. This is nothing but sufficient condition for divergent series. Therefore, according to this condition, the given series, namely series cos of 1 by n, is divergent. Now let us prove that the series n divided by n plus 1 whole to the power n is divergent. Here, let us take un is equals to n by n plus 1 whole to the power n. Since n is a natural number, the whole value, namely n by n plus 1 whole power n, is greater than 0 for all n. Therefore, the limit of un is equal to limit of n by n plus 1 whole to the power n as n tends to infinity. Whenever we are going to take the limit, normally we eliminate n and the power of n. Now, we try to get the factor, namely 1 by n. So that when we take limit as n tends to infinity, 1 by n tends to 0. Therefore, here in the denominator, we take n out. When we take n out from the denominator, we get n into 1 plus 1 by n. So that this n and this n get cancelled. That is equals to limit of 1 by 1 plus 1 by n to the power n as n tends to infinity. Now, we are going to apply the limit. Limit of 1 by 1 plus 1 by n to the power n as n tends to infinity. Whenever we apply limit, we have to apply limit for the numerator and denominator, and every factor in the numerator, every factor in the denominator, or every term in the denominator, every term in the numerator. Here, 1 is a constant, nothing is there, n is not there. If n is there, we apply limit for that. Since 1 is there, n is not there, therefore apply limit to only the denominator. Limit of 1 plus 1 by n to the power n as n tends to infinity. We know that limit of 1 plus 1 by n to the power n as n tends to infinity is e. Therefore, the limit is equals to 1 by e, which is not equal to 0 because e value is between 2 and 3. E value is between 2 and 3. Therefore, 1 by e cannot be 0. Therefore, by the above note, as we discussed in the previous problem, the series un that is equal to series n by n plus 1 whole power n, which is being a positive series of positive terms, and the limit of un as n tends to infinity is not equal to 0. Therefore, the given series diverges and diverges to plus infinity. Therefore, the given series is divergent. Now let us discuss the convergence of the series 1 by 1 plus 2 power minus 1 plus 2 by 1 plus 2 power minus 2 plus 3 divided by 1 plus 2 whole power minus 3 plus so on. When you say convergence, when you say convergence of the series, we know that we are going to test the behavior of the series. That is, whether the series is convergent or divergent or oscillates. Now, the nth term of the given series. In the first two problems, we were given the nth term. But here, nth term is not given. We should know the nth term of the given series so that we can apply limit to the nth term. Therefore, we will write the nth term of the series that is equals to. Here, look at the numerator. 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, the nth term will be n divided by. 1 is common in every denominator. The first term in the denominator is 1. Therefore, 1 plus. Here, 2 is also common. See here, 2 power minus 1 plus 2 power minus 2 plus 2 power minus 3. So 1 plus 2 power minus is common. But when it comes to the power, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. If you consider the third term, this is the third term. First term, second term. Third term is 3 by 1 plus 2 power minus 3. Here, 1 plus 2 power minus is common. So 3 by 3. Therefore, the nth term will be n whole divided by 1 plus 2 to the power minus n. What is n? N is a natural number. Therefore, the whole term is positive for all n. The first term is positive, second term positive, third term positive. Every term in the series is positive. That is, the given series is a series of positive terms. Let us find the limit of the nth term. That is equals to. Here we have taken an as the nth term. So limit of an as n tends to infinity is equals to limit of n divided by 1 plus 2 to the power minus n as n tends to infinity. That is, we have to replace n by infinity. Therefore, what happened here? N that becomes infinity whole divided by 1 plus 2 to the power minus n. Therefore, it is minus infinity, and hence infinity divided by 1 plus 2 power minus infinity is 0, because 2 power minus infinity will be 1 by 2 to the power infinity. 2 to the power infinity is infinity, so 1 by infinity is 0, and hence 2 to the power minus infinity is 0. Therefore, the value is infinity. That is not equal to 0. Thus, the given series is a series of positive terms, and the limit of whose nth term is not equal to 0. Therefore, the given series is divergent.